Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So today I am going to start a new topic on Laravel, which is Laravel routing. So let's get started and work on this tutorial. So first, let's open our project of Laravel. So first, open VS Code. And here, I am going to open my previously created project of Laravel. So open it in folder. Then setting the path. Access. And Laravel. Now select the folder. And here you can see my project has been open. So first let's close it. And also if you don't know about how to create project in Laravel, so you can follow my previous tutorial. And also let's install some extension to make our work easier. So click on view, click on extension, and let's install Laravel. And here you can see Laravel snippet. Install it. Do one more thing. Just restart your VS Code. So close it. And again open it. Now after that, let's close this page. And let's run our project. So click on terminal. New terminal. After that, PHP. Partition. Serve. And here you can see my project has been running on localhost. So let's open this link. And you can see Laravel project has been running. Now after that, let's work on our routing. So let's create some routes in Laravel. So let's work on it. So first, open routes. And here is our file, web.php. So open this file. And here is our simple route. Currently it is opening a welcome page. But for us, let's remove everything and do everything from start. So first, let's create a simple route. Let's add route. After that, colon. And first using get method. So get. Then you need to pass the address of URL. Like suppose that I want to access page 1. After that, you need to create a function. So simply create function. So simply return simple page 1 example. After that, save this file. Here semicolon is missing. Save it again. Back to Chrome. Refresh page. And you can see simple page 1 example is working perfect. So in this way you can create a simple page in Laravel using routing. Now let's see second example. So again route. And here currently you can see it is showing some suggestion. So you can also use this suggestion or type it manually. So again select page 2 and function. This time I am returning return. Now return using HTML tag. So in previous I show you a simple text example, but here in page 2 I am using a simple HTML example. So simple HTML content. Again, save this page. Also here spelling is mistake. So function, save it again. Back to Chrome. Now open page 2. And you can see a simple HTML content using route in Laravel. Now after that, let's see our next example, which is how you can pass a value from URL. So let's see route in get. then slash users, and here adding ID. So you can access this ID in your page. So again, function dollar ID, and here return h2 hello user, and here simply add the user. Now save this file again and back to browser. So copy it back to browser. After that again users 1, and you can see hello user 1. So in this way you can pass multiple values from URLs in Laravel using routes. Now let's see next example, which is optional parameter, means you don't need to pass or you can pass by default value. So let's see how you can use a optional. So for this, just copy this simple. This time here ID, add a question mark, and here setting default value. So default value equal to 1, and here users example 2. Save it, copy it back to browser and change it to enter. Currently you can see it is using default ID, which is 1. You can see I set a default ID, which is 1, and if I pass some value like 2, you can see its value has been changed. Now let's see next example, which is how you can pass multiple parameters. So again, simply copy this example and paste it. This time here simply add multiple like name, and here dollar name. After that here simply name dollar name. Now save this file again and user multiparam it. Save it back to Chrome and change this to multiparam. So first passing ID like 1 or 2 or 3, then passing username like admin, and you can see it is working perfect. Hello user ID is 3 and name is admin. So in this way you can use multiple parameters in route in Laravel. Now let's see next part. Now you can also set names in route like this, name like h2. So you can use this name to access the route when you are working in controller or any view pages. So you need to set this name. After that save this also. Now let's see next example, which is group routing. So route, after that prefix, and here adding a route like slash admin. After that group, and here adding function. So in this way you can create a group of routings. Now here you need to add some route like route get slash page 1, and here function return page 1. Again copy it, paste it. This time change it to page 2, and page 2. Now here I created a simple group of URLs example, so you can't access the directly page like page 1 and page 2. So you need to access these pages inside prefix admin. So let's check, copy page 1, or let's copy page 1 directly. And here if I open page 1, can see it's open a first example, but not this page. So if I try to open /admin, so let's check /admin/page1, and you can see it is working perfect. And if I try to open this page, so /admin/page2. So in this way, you can use a group of URLs in route in Laravel. Now after that, let's see next example, which is Laravel routing 404 page. So simply route, after that fallback function. So this page only call when our page is not found. So let's return some message. Return 404 page. So this will only call when our URL does not exist. So save this page and let's check it's working or not. So suppose that let's open a URL like page 3. So let's check what happened if I open page 3, and you can see it is opening 404 page. So when our page is not exist, it will open our 404 page. Now after that, let's see next example, which is post method. So route post, and here you need to pass the post URL like form save, and after that here function, and here you need to add a request object. So request $request. Now this will only work when we call this page by using post method. Now after that, let's return some data. So return post example, and let's import this request. So copy this request, so save it, and let's import the request. So here use illuminate/http/requests. Now save this file and let's check, open this page, and you can see it is showing 404 page because our method is inside post method. We can't call this method using get. So let's try to open this URL using post method. So let's open postman. So just copy the URL and change the method to post. Click on send, and you can see it is showing page expired because we are not passing the CSRF token. So I will show this page example when we are working with forms, and also show the example what is the use of this request. So you can use this request object to get the form data, like form data, files and everything from this request object. So I will show this example when we are working with forms in Laravel. Now after that, let's see one more example, which is route any. So this will call only, so this will call from any method, whether it is post or get. So any method function. Return work for both get and post. Then save this page and let's try to open this URL. So if I try to open using get method, you can see it's working for get method. Now if I try to again call this method using postman, so let's copy it, send, and you can see it is working, but it is showing page expired because we are not passing this CSRF token. So I will show this example how you can pass this CSRF token when we are calling post method. Now after that, again back to VS Code, and let's see. Now currently you are saying I am using every method inside route. but you can also link a controller here instead of directly linking with function. So let's see how you can use controller in Laravel and link a route method to a controller. So for this you need to create a controller. So let's check how you can create a controller. So first open terminal, new terminal. So for creating controller you need to run command php partition make controller, then you need to pass the controller name. So here giving controller name like page controller, and you can see controller created successfully. So close it, and after that if you open your app, open http, open controller, and you can see a page controller has been created. If you open this, it is showing a simple class. Now after that you need to create a method. So let's add a method like public function page 3, and after that return simple page example linked to route to controller. Save this file also, and let's link this function to our route. So again let's add a method. So route then get method plus page 3, and after that so here simply add page controller, which is our controller name. You can see page controller is our controller name. Add the rate, then you need to pass the method, which is page 3. Copy it and simply paste it. After that giving semicolon, save it. Now back to Chrome and let's check whether it is working or not. So back to Chrome and try to open page 3. And okay, you need to import page controller. So here use app slash http slash http slash controllers slash page controller. Now save it this file. Now save this file and again back to Chrome, refresh page, and it is showing target class does not exist. So here in Laravel it will not work like this. So for this you need to import it completely like this. So in Laravel 8 there is lots of changes. So it will work like this. You can see I pass the complete path of our page controller. Now save it, refresh page, and you can see it is working perfect. And also there is another alternative way you can use it like this. So let's create a method again, which is page 4, and here it is page 4. After that let's again open the page, copy it, page 4, alternate way, save it, and this time instead of using like this, so simply remove it and use it like page controller. After that page controller class. After that you need to pass your method name, so page 4. And after that you need to import this page controller. So just import it, use app slash http slash controller slash page controller, save it, and again after that back to Chrome, try to open page 4. And it is showing error. Okay, here it should be double colon. Save it, refresh page, and again it is showing some error. Okay, here it should be controllers. You can see it's controllers. Again, save this page, refresh page, and you can see it is working perfect. So in this way you can link a route to a controller using these two types of method. First, it is using simple way, which is passing the controller name, then @ method name, and second is using controller name, then pass the method name. So you can use any method which you like. So I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. Please like our video and please subscribe our channel.